Mic check. Everyday Superpower signing in, where we talk body language, nonverbal communication, that is. We talk relationships, game, human dynamics, everything in between. This one should be a good one then. Let me just sort a couple of things out one moment. I tried to do this not so long back with a television broadcasted dating program, and I got copyright striked. So hopefully, even though as far as copyright's concerned, what I'm doing is completely fair use. So I guess the powers that be can sort of overextend their powers, and you know, laws don't abide to them. But we've got like a YouTube video here. To be honest with you, I quite simply say, and if you do like what we're doing, because we talk body language on this channel, I'm actually going to break it down and show it to you. If you do want to see more of this, I'll tell you this now, leave a comment, let me know if you want to see more of this, and I most definitely will do, as long as it's completely fine to do. All right, call me old and whatnot, you know what I mean? But yeah, I did get copyright stricken last time, and it kind of pissed me off, to be honest. I just quite simply searched Google. I didn't even search Google. Sorry, I'm stumbling and bumbling, people. It's the first time doing this, innit? I searched people on a date, to put it simply, and I came across this video by a company called Nectar, and it's entitled 50 Strangers Swipe on Each Other versus one. So it's not necessarily one-on-one dating, and there will be a lot of manufactured or attempt of manufactured like expression and emotion, because they know they are being videoed and so on and so forth. But we are going to break down the body language. I'll talk some game with you. We'll see what comes up, to put a long story short. Let me see if I can change the FPS, because I don't know how fast this is going to move. I'll see you in 1 second. Right, it should be on 60 FPS. We'll just get playing, just so I can see how hittery-jittery it is. And I say that purely as, oh, fuck it. Who cares, man? Let's just jump into it. But you know what I mean? We're talking about micro-expressions and stuff like that, which might be a little lesser easy to identify, but I'll be able to slow it down for you and whatnot.
Hi, I'm Nut. I'm back hosting the biggest episode of Versus One ever.
Okay, cool. So it's not as fluid as I would like it to be, but it's a good start, right? So let's watch this. See if I can get these subtitles off, because we don't need. Cool, let's go. So peace, one love, people. Let me break some stuff down to you. Right, this is just the introduction. Right, so first and foremost, let's just break down. If you can see the people identifying here, look how interesting this is. You can see the nervous energy expressed through the involuntary movements of each of these people. They are electrified. So first thing I saw was this guy here in the brown jacket, third man across. Watch this guy. And then as you see him act in such a manner, you see the mirroring behavior begin to flow through the crowd here. Watch. You see it in the women as well. So this woman here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people down, the dark-skinned woman, or it seems so, she starts preening herself. The woman just in front in the orange dress, she's currently preening herself. And by preening, I mean attempting to make herself look better. And you might think, oh, well, this is obvious, blah, 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 why wouldn't she? You will see this manifest in your life, whether you be at work, whether you be walking down the street. And you have to ask, why is she trying to make herself look good? Is it for me? Is it for the next person? Okay.
25 single women and 25 single men swiping yes or no on.
One thing I just clocked on, to look at the second guy, watch him rub his hands. Watch him rub his hands. One more.
25 single women and
right here, look.
Men swiping yes or no on.
Do you know why he's rubbing his hands? If he was to rub it fast, might be thinking about his money, might be excited. He's rubbing his hands slowly because his palms are sweating. Real talk. His palms are sweating. We've got nerve endings on the behinds of our hands, as well as the, both sides of our hands, let's be real. which feels good, which relieves ourselves when we are under high stress. We do this unconsciously, or at least we might think there is a real reason behind it, but no, it's a pacifying behavior. So we feel good when we do this. So when we hold hands in front of us, it's the same thing. It might regress us back to an earlier stage when we held hands with our parents and so on and so forth. It might regress them back to an easier time in childhood. They are still the same person.
Starting now.
Right, let's have a little deek. Let's see the lineup here. Who have we got? So we're gonna start talking game as well. All right. So this guy's already in a losing battle just due to his height. I'm gonna be real with you. I'm not gonna get you onto no black pill crap and all this and that. But it is what it is. Biologically speaking, she's probably gonna be more entertained by a taller man, especially because she is a considerably tall woman. If you look at the men, she is standing at head height to the second guy and actually seems to be taller than the rest. So truth be told, this isn't gonna be abnormal for her. She might have been well prepared for this. Now let's just have a little deek of what's going on. So you see her arms before her, yeah? Let's see how much you can see. One check. So let me give you a disclaimer, right? We have to read these things in clusters, and we need to break these things down over time. If we just pause at any particular moment, we're going to see some signs indicative of some behaviors or feelings or emotions. But with that being said, it might not necessarily be completely truthful unless we get the big picture. But with that being said, I'll tell you what I see. Let me see if I can make myself a bit smaller here, because it'll do us all some good. So you see her, yeah? Her hands are covering her crotch, yeah? It's not a great sign as far as attraction is concerned, but you may have to question, let's bring it all together, is she actually pushing her cleavage together? What does he see? She pushing her cleavage together to pronounce her breasts? Or is she hiding her stomach? Probably not hiding her stomach as much as concealing her genitals, if you look at the positioning of her hands, blocking it off. A chastity belt, per se. Now, him, on the other hand, he's putting his best foot forward. He seems quite comfortable in the way that he's exposing his complete ventral side, his chest. Look at the guy behind him. He's concealing his crotch as well. So here we go. This is the magic. Look at these people, man. This is fantastic. So as a man, you don't want to do what this second guy in the queue is doing. This taller guy looking to the side. You don't want to be like him, because he's covering his crotch up. He's scared. He's fearful, right? Do you know primitive men? Do you know chimpanzees? They will attack the genitals, the fingers, before anything else. The primitive in him is saying, I'm threatened. I need to conceal and cover my genital area. The guy in front of the other hand, he's coming in. He's laughing. He's smiling. Seems confident enough from the distance. What he's doing is actually accenting his genital area by creating an arrow that directs down to there. Not only that, but due to his small stature, what he's doing is acting more territorial. He's taking up more space and enlarging himself like a peacock by doing this. So he's not coming in here in an unconfident manner, right? Look at this lady. Can we see her? Look at the lady, three people back with the brown jumper on. What she's doing is she's gripping onto her forearm. Now, when I talked to you earlier about the holding of the arms and the regressive experience a person may feel in relation to when they were young and youthful and only developing that feeling of, oxytocin and the hormonal rush of positive endorphins that you feel when a parental figure of such, or maybe even your first girlfriend or whatever, starts to hold your hand and you feel that good positive experience. She is holding on to her forearm, which makes me think, in a regressive sense, when she was young, when she was a child, somebody would hold on to a forearm to console her. Everything's going to be all right. You're going to be fine. That's where she finds comfort. That's her inner child. All right. Don't tell me I'm not talking game right here. Don't tell me I'm not talking game. Seems like the woman after her knows she's on camera and she's just trying to look good. Look at how she's positioned herself. Almost awkwardly, I would say. Almost unnaturally. Look at how she's revealing her neck to the camera in a sexual manner. She's chosen that side because the camera is pointing on that side, you know. And to expose the neck is to expose your vulnerability in a feminine and submissive fashion. We're talking game! Come on! this guy's biting his lower lip, or maybe he's quite simply... Hold on. Look at their expressions, people. Look at their expressions. Her hands right now. Let's see if her hands... I think her hands make this starting position now. Initially. Hold on. Look at how her hands come up in a praying fashion. So she went from potentially protruding her chest to not only concealing them, but to actually praying to the gods above. Does that sound stupid? You tell me. What do you see before you in that freeze frame? I did a video saying take a snapshot of them. When you see something in particular, imagine how it would be perceived if someone just took a camera photo of you. Look at what's happening before you. What's she praying to? And you see this amplified here when she gives you the fully frontal. She is in a praying, steepled position right about now. Okay, she's got a closed lip smile. If that was organic and she really felt happy emotions, her teeth will be fully out. She feels uncomfortable, anxious. It's a little bit of a forced smile, all right? Him, on the other hand, I don't want to cast judgment because I don't actually know how his facial structure is made up at this moment in time. But it seems like he's, I don't know, he could potentially be biting down ever so subtly on that bottom lip of his. Little micro expression of fear there. Let's see if we can go back on that. Right, let's get to it. Wait, so I don't even know how this program works. They've both said no. Oh, and that's why she's praying, potentially. I guess you can switch to the side no matter what means, but she's praying and... Okay, let's keep going. I digress. Right, she's walking down, not making eye contact. Him, on the other hand, I'm talking about the new people now. The other people are walking towards each other. Take a look at these two who have just left. She is the first one to leave. She's so far off in comparison to this next guy. She could not wait to leave. Look at how fast she is leaving the scene. He's only just set off, right? Whereas this next woman is turning up, she's got her head held down. She does not want to engage in eye contact with this guy. He, on the other hand, does want to. He's concealing his crotch in fear, okay? Don't do this, fellas. Don't do this if you're trying to attract someone. This all works on a subconscious basis. They will pay attention to this. Okay, so what happens is she initially walks up. And she momentarily glances at him for a millisecond. Watch her. She quickly looks aside to the camera. She cuts off with him as soon as she can do. Watch. Bing! He's still looking at her. He's not even got to look at her. She's already looking at the side away. He's pointing directly at her. He knows what he wants. He's turned up. He's got his best shirt on. He's like, I'm a tall fella. I'm blonde. I'm handsome. I got beautiful blue eyes. Why wouldn't she be attracted to me? She's the mirror image of me. He's pointing towards her. He's ready. So there is a non-verbal cue as to whether the hands are facing upwards or as to whether the hands are facing forward or bloody blah. There's no uniform way of doing it. So we must pay attention as to how this is working. All right. What do you think, people? What do you think? She looks at him side across to identify who stays there before her. She's not looking at him direct. She's bladed, all right? To be intimate and to be fully aligned and to be fully interested, there would be a 100% direct forward motion, okay? I would say it's across. I would say he's interested and she's not. But is he going to read the room? Because the thing is as well, to save face, who's going to read the room? Let's find out. Nope. Boom! Let's go back. This is what nonverbal communication will tell you, people. I just want to read this guy for a second. And look at this, the high frequency as he laughs, as he giggles. It's, I don't want to call it feminine, but it is. It's discomfort. Have you ever called somebody out, another man, and gone, oh, it wasn't me. Oh. That shock and surprise is indicative of somebody who's a little bit hurt, a little bit in their emotion. He giggles and laughs to sort of flush it out. It's obviously an embarrassing moment. That's the only time she smiled. She didn't smile seeing the guy. She smiled seeing him fall to his knees. All right, look at this. Look, well, I was going to say he moves off first. It must be that she stays on, given that she's all right with him. She goes until she goes. Right, let's see this guy. So this guy is now in competition with the next man as opposed to having to impress her. So there's a dynamic going on now. Does she seem stone-hearted by just brushing everyone off? Because she will have to at some point fight the friction of how she is received in this, all right? Look at the congruence with her environment. Nope. She is cute, though. She is cute. I do like her. So this guy walks up. Okay, they both said no to each other. And he rushed into that, to be honest. I like to see their expressions. So he's come on. They've looked at each other. It's almost like they've... Wait a minute. Watch out what he does before he moves, right? Wait a minute. So pay attention, right? Attention to detail. You see this guy. Watch. He identifies what motion she's doing before he acts. Look at his hands. Hold on. Let me stop that. Look at his hands. He could very easily sway to the other direction. It's almost as like he was waiting to do so. And then he sees she's moving in a particular manner. And he follows her. He mirrors her. Don't try and con me, man. Do you see that? So watch this guy's hand gesture. It's almost as if he was going to swipe yes until he assessed where she was going. Watch. You see, the sway was about to swing in the opposite direction. Hey! Nah, that didn't fool me. They've both stepped in together. Let's see these two. All right. Two new parties have arrived. She's in her high heels. He still seems to be a little bit taller than her. So as far as height is concerned, we're not in a bad position to be in, all right? He seems cool, calm. Posture could be a bit better. Who cares? Okay? She's exposing a little bit of her shoulder, exposing in an indirect sensual means, as we relieve our clothing, as we move our clothing, indirectly we start to strip of our clothes. But she is still quiet, concealed. She's not willing to expose her forearms, her wrists, which would be a good sign, right? She's not swept her hair over one or two of sides of her neck. She's somewhat concealed as far as her erogenous zones are concerned. This guy, let's see what he's saying. Well, actually, let's have a look how fast she looks to the side. All right, she steps one step forward. How many steps forward does this guy take? Because that's quite important, right? One, two. He takes two steps forward. She takes one, right? Clock game. One, two. She just takes the one step. That's symbolic. He looks over to her. She looks to him. Her head's a little bit ajar again. Okay. Her head's a little bit ajar again. He's looking directly forward. One thing I just clocked onto is there's a momentary glance down from this guy. All right. Hold on. This might be so minute. Let's slow this one down. Shit, I don't need to... Hold on, people. Hold on. Playback speed. Let's slow this down to 0.5, see if this is sufficient. All right, two steps in versus one. I mean, she doesn't even stop moving before she cuts eye contact off with him, turns around. She's not selling herself, all right? She's not selling herself. Arguably, you could say she was exposing her neck to him, but she's not because her hair is concealing her neck. She looks over to him. He, at this point, looks down when he makes eye contact. And I don't know if this is in a submissive sense or if he's checking her body out, but this is what I clocked onto. He looks up and he just jumps in. He's the first one to move. He can't wait to get out of there. He knew where he stood. Right. If you want to see more, let me know. Yeah, leave a comment down below and I'll continue on with this. Other than that, I'm signing out, people. Thanks for joining me.